All right, Michael. So see if you can tell me where we're going here. So just as a reminder, I've erased a bunch of stuff so I can make some room. We're trying to maximize this cost function J prime sub pi, which is basically the sum of the mutual information between every single feature and its parents. And I want to point out that that actually induces a graph, in fact, a fully connected graph. So here I've drawn a bunch of nodes as part of a graph and all the edges between them. Each one of these nodes is going to represent a feature, an x of I, and what's going to go on the edges is going to be the mutual information between them. So I now have a fully connected graph, which has the mutual information between each pair of nodes, all n squared edges, and I want to find a subgraph of this graph, in particular a tree, that maximizes these sums. So any ideas how I do that, Michael? First off, does that make sense what I just said?
Yeah. I mean, it's very interesting, right? So we're trying to pick each time we pick an edge, it's actually saying that what we're going to care about the relationship between this pair of variables, and we're only allowing edges. We're not allowing because that involves two nodes. We're not getting sets of three or five or however many nodes larger than that. And so mm-hmm. we want to be considering a subset of edges that form a tree that has the highest total information content.
That's exactly right.
And that's a minimum spanning tree.
Well, not quite.
That's a maximum spanning tree.
That's exactly right. It turns out that finding the tree consistent with this graph, such that this is true, is in fact the same thing as finding the maximum spanning tree, which we all vaguely remember from our algorithms class.
So you said it was terribly painful, but it's actually not.
It's terribly easily painful. So that's really neat. We turned the problem of finding the best distribution, and in particular the best dependency tree, independent of the true underlying distribution, I want to point out, into a problem of a well-known, well-understood computer science problem of finding the maximum spanning tree. And if we find the maximum spanning tree, then we have found the best dependency tree.
So to be honest, I don't remember maximum spanning tree. Minimum spanning tree, can we just solve a maximum spanning tree problem by, I don't know, negating the edges or so?
Yes.
Or adding? Okay.
That's exactly right. So everywhere in there where you pick a max, you pick a min, or you just label them with the negative of the mutual information, and it's the same thing. I think that this particular form of writing it as a maximum mutual information is easier to think about.
Okay.
And what you'll do when you find the maximum spanning tree is you'll end up with, in fact, some tree, and you're done.
Well, so now you need to tell me, because the structure was a directed structure, so can we then pick any node and call it the root and then do a depth-first traversal or something?
Absolutely. So first off, I want to point out there's two different algorithms that you could use. Do you remember the two algorithms you could use to find the maximum spanning tree, or the two famous ones anyway?
I'm going to go with Prim and Kruskal, but I know there's others.
No, those are the two that they teach you in algorithms class. And it turns out for this particular one, you want to use Prim, because Prim is...
It's proper.
It is proper, Prim and proper. Prim is the proper algorithm to use whenever you have a strongly connected graph. It just happens to be faster.
You mean densely connected graph.
What did I say?
Strongly.
Okay, densely connected. Right, a densely connected graph. And by the way, this is a fully connected graph, which is about as dense a connected graph as you can get. So Prim's algorithm runs in time quadratic, or polynomial anyway, in the number of edges. And so it's actually fairly efficient as things go, because as we know, in theory, if it's polynomial, it might as well be free. And there you go. So use Prim's algorithm, you find the maximum spanning tree, and you are done.
All right, I'm going to need reminding where this is all plugging in.
Okay, that's exactly what I was going to
do. This is a cool diversion, but...
Right, so it is actually worth pointing out that this was a bit of a diversion that we had to do. Let's go back to the original algorithm that we had and just point out what we would be doing here.